I I love it. It's not like it.
Right? So back to sacred space, and you create actually know. But you don't actually need any of that. It all just what helps you focus more and more and more on what you're doing. Right? And then, once you've done it, like two handles, you can suss it out. If you want to get in touch with this, you can actually work it out for yourself. You need handles, you need incense, salt for cleansing. You actually make sure that nobody's going to disturb you. You walk out, you make the space for yourself. Now, in a coven, you're supposed to get in something called a code of power. You can do that yourself. You can either smoke another joint, get high, you can take something. You can dance, you can move, you can walk around, you can do whatever to get to that pitch where you feel you call down the god and you call up the god and the goddess to be with you. You focus on that by itself, you make it work for you.
Versus drugs. Now this is not quite the completed one because there's a bit in this about how disgusting heroin is and crack and crap like that. But anyway, when you're young and smoking dope, you often fall asleep. Getting out of it, it's called, as if we all were sheep. But dope can open up your mind and let you breathe with trees, reveal the mystery of life and help you ride the breeze. And smoking dope's political, make no mistake in that. It separates the shaman from the greedy plutocrat. It frees your thoughts and helps you fight that bitch conditioning, the thing that keeps us victims of the church, the state, the king. So skin up, girls, or light a pipe. Get into it, I say. Too old for sex, I may well get, but not too old to play. I'll now read the prose bit. The main thing to remember about medication is not to take any. There has been more damage done by prescribed drugs such as Valium than has ever occurred through smoking any form of marijuana I have ever heard of. And I've heard of a few.
And it's not tested on animals.
Absolutely, absolutely. Medication is dished out to old people to keep them quiet and malleable. I have no intention of keeping quiet, and I'm not going to have anybody handling me, thank you very much. Even that latest top of the pops for menopausal women hormone replacement therapy is derived from horse urine, and nobody seems remotely concerned that we might all start whinnying and pawing the ground one day. Perhaps they assume all us old girls are so desperate we'll take anything. No reason for manufacturers to think otherwise, considering how we've allowed consumerism to swallow us all up
but that's another story. Of course, there's a place for legal drugs if you have an accident or an infection, but they are few and far between. Sensible people get into herbal medicine, and part of the traditional wisdom of the crone was her knowledge of herbs and how to administer them. Today it's called alternative medicine and is easily available through health food shops and mystic shops and healing centers and places like that. We don't have to go out at midnight under the full moon with our hot little sickles clutched in our arthritic old hands anymore. Not unless we want to. And there's a whole array of books to teach us what we want to know. Or therapists and healers, if you can afford them. And very helpful shop assistants, if only we bother to ask. There's no need to be a victim all your life to the mysteries of medicine. Doctors do their best, but a lot of them are too overworked to have much time for anything and are trained only to set bones and administer chemical drugs. Well, that's a slight overstatement, but only slight. And don't talk to me about genetic research. That's devil's work, if ever I've heard of any. Now, what the law incorrectly labels soft drugs and makes illegal is another ballgame altogether. I call them the planet's gift to consciousness raising. Me and that wonderful late American comedian Bill Hicks. And to what are we both referring? Marijuana and magic mushrooms, of course. Throughout history, these have been used as herbal medicine and to experience religious visions. It's quicker than fasting and just as effective. There's even a peyote church somewhere in the USA, but I don't think they'll let me join, even if I swear I'm a bona fide Christian. South American Indians used to save some of their coca leaves for the old folks, and that's before the Spaniards and the Mafia got their hands on the cocaine business and ruined it. And what better to give an aged Chinaman than a nice pipe of opium to while away his time with? Sweet dreams. It's a fact that most of the greatest English poetry of the 19th century was written under the influence of opium, and many a Victorian baby was lulled to sleep with a nice spoonful of laudanum, which I believe was opium soaked in brandy. That would put a smile on a Christmas pudding. The problem with all these drugs is not that they're illegal. That's an inconvenience, not a problem. The problem is that there are too few competent guides around today to lead us through the labyrinths of our minds. And taking them alone or in a social situation can lead you into paranoia or Bruegel's hell. So of course, with perseverance, you'll get through the sticky stages, but especially with a little counseling or analysis on the way, but it's a dangerous path to travel alone. It's perhaps fortunate that opium is rarely available in this country these days. It can be addictive if you've got that sort of personality, and certainly it's something else. Its manufactured derivative heroin causes nothing but grief and should be avoided at all costs. Likewise, crack, derived from cocaine. But a little of the real thing. When you're old, what have you got to lose? A lifetime prejudices? For a pleasant evening's dreaming or a fascinating conversation with a few good friends, I can recommend nothing better than a nice pipe of hashish or a joint if you're a fag hag like someone I could mention not a million miles from here. And for those not in the know, and this book is going to be published, hashish is made from the oil of the marijuana plant, where the leaves can make you giggly, the oil can make you visionary. Decisions, decisions, what shall I try tonight? Neither is addictive, nor does regular use lead on to dabbling in harder drugs. That's an urban myth. If you want to go to hell, you may take the scenic route. If you want to stay in heaven, nothing is going to drag you out of there. And in particular for old people, the therapeutic pain-killing benefits of marijuana are incomparable. Queen Victoria used it, for goodness sake. And then I'll cut to the end. No, you would would be well advised to budget for a little bit of dope out of your weekly pension. It'll be money well spent, especially if among your gang of green and geriatrics, you can count the neighbourhood dope dealer as one of your long-time friends. Or it's one of the treats you can get the kids to bring you on their weekly visit to Stalag Geriatrica, otherwise known as the old folks' home. I bet you bought them enough sweeties when they were the helpless ones. Okay, that's enough. I feel really conspicuous and awkward standing up here on this cellar spot. What?
Your paganism, your Wiccanism and shamanism, and whatever else you want to call your spirituality, then come out from your spiritual space inside your rooms, inside the clubs, and get out into the open air. Come to Salisbury Hill. Join us. Meet some real pagans. Yeah? Come to the M11 link, which is not too far, and it's still going on. We're still fighting. And at Twyford Down on the 2nd of July, we're having a mass trespass.
Right.
Yeah? Go for it. Practice what you preach.
Knows it's happening. It's probably going to go through. But if we all stick together and all oppose it, it can be unworkable. Remember that. That's all I want to tell you. And try and get along to this mass trespass. And try and make it known that you are going to continue to protest no matter what they say.
Brilliant. When's the mass protest? When's the protest? The 2nd of July. Okay? Thank you. Now, I don't know your name. Greg.
I'd like to tell you a little story, and I hope that you can work the moral out. A long, long time ago, before all the world began, there was a cave, and there were 10 people in the cave, bound to the walls. They could see nothing except the shadows of the outside world reflecting inside the cave. One day, one person in the cave broke free and walked towards the entrance and looked out. And he couldn't quite open his eyes, but when he managed to just open them and see what the actual world was like and see the beauty of the world, he felt free and he felt that he had to go back and tell everyone in the cave, it's actually really nice outside and the shadows aren't quite what you really think they are. It's actually much better and there's a big sun and everything's wonderful. But sadly, everyone in the cave didn't believe him. So he set them free, one by one, and let them go out into the outside world. And there they found for themselves that conditioning doesn't pay. Thank you.
Seems to be going on all over the world, all over the country, but nothing seems to be done in London. passed it back, so the person at the very back of the room is holding onto the tape. And try not to touch it with your try and keep it as sticky as possible.
Is everyone here?
Of course we're here.
Is everyone here? I really wish you
correct! Excuse me.
I'd like everyone to close your eyes, please. Everybody, close your eyes.
That's us, brother.
That's everybody.
And you.
I don't want people peeking if you know what I'm saying. Right,
We peek!
Keep your eyes shut, please. Eyes shut.
Right, is my bag around anywhere? I don't know, I'm seeing a really old bag. I've lost it, right? I don't know where it is.
Downstairs.
Feet. What's at your feet?
This is a t-shirt that I just bought tonight, yeah? And it's by this company called Infinity. Right?
With our eyes shut?
With your eyes shut.
All right. Lovely.
You can't see it if your eyes are open. Hello?
Why not?
I don't know, because I'm making it up.
That doesn't fit you.
Do you want a bet?
Yeah, go on, try one. Let's see. This is better. And we
pee. Is that my new shirt?
Yeah.
Oh. Right, one person from the audience, please.
But I intend to. It costs 40 pence, right?
Right.
And,
Come on, Luke.
Right, so I bought it at the Head Media Stall, which sells underground literature.
Naughty boy!
Sit down!
I've been a very naughty boy, you know. I've been a really naughty...
Sit down, yeah?
Right, okay, so I'm now going to take this badge off, yeah? Alright, I'll keep it off.
You want to take your shirt off?
Yeah, right.
We are all in this together.
Yes!
Good. I'm glad you're all here. At this point, I want to put on a tape.
It's a video projector set up.
No.
Turn around. It's fucking scary, isn't it? you. I am also going to ask what it's about, because you come here, and therefore it's about something to you. Some of you come here regularly. Most of the people who are in this room, because you don't come up here unless you know about it, really. So what's it about? He says it's about money. Who said that? Hands up. He said it's about money. He should ask our bank manager, really, because we thought it might be about some money that we first started, because we'd like to earn a living. But that's not exactly why it's turned out. Because what we're doing is we're putting on, we're just on a show. We're putting a show that most people can cost £6,000 to £8,000. The people that are coming here and living on the show, they're all people that have been out on the edge, at the parties, in the fields, at the festivals, on the barricades, wherever, in from out there, and they do it for less because they're doing it for a purpose. So we're able to afford to put on a good show, cost us that much less, than we take out the door. Now, you take the word for that or not, it doesn't matter. If anybody's really interested, I'll actually show them some things that we can make them shit. So, got that? It's not about money. One of the things that it is about knowing the doorway. So some people that come here, well, you know the score, you've been out there, you know what you're fighting for, you know what it's all about. A good half of the people that come here are those clubs. They're clubbers, they're people, they've got day jobs, they're bringing stuff, they don't know what it's here about, what it's about. And you are here to tell them. Yeah. Otherwise there's no point. Otherwise it's a nightclub, which is boring. It's also a shit way to make money if that's what you're doing. So it's not a bit about something else. You're here to tell the average Joe in the street, who is not an average Joe, to make you know what's going on, but you're very pissed off human being. But they don't. And you're here to tell them. So that's one thing it's about. It's called a festival in a club, or a festival indoors. Well, you can't really do that because it's like imitation. But we call it that so that people come here and they get a sense of what it's about. They meet you, they see the stalls, they hear the music, they hear what we're banging on about, they hear the criminal justice stuff, they hear all that business, and they get a sense that something's going on. Accessible to them. We made it cheap and we made it legal. They're not terrified of, they're not worried about whether the old girl are going to burst in and whether their mum's going to find out. That's further down the line for them. But this is a place where they come and you can affect them. And that's vital. So you're really, part of the main attraction. What else is it about? What else is it about? Somebody tell me.
It's about love.
Right, this is a place where people from all different bits of our society, or the whole tribe, communicate with each other. It's also true to say that this is about transformation. It's about transformation of consciousness in a very practical sense, because there's 35 people who work on this, 35 to 40 people who work on this every week. They're used to doing stuff in the fields where whatever you do, they're grateful. Somebody comes along with a bit to a party, it's just great that you put it off. Here it's got to be proper music, here it's got to be properly dressed, here it's got to be decent visuals. So we're learning how to do it properly. We're learning how to take a vision and put it in
form.
But we come to it and transform it on many levels. Everybody sitting in this room, including me, obviously, is untransformed. Some of us are meat eaters, not this one, but some of us are. Some of us don't know what's happening with the law. Some of us don't know how to be free and feel safe. And touching someone else, being with, enjoying, dancing, losing it, getting out of it, if that's what it takes to push you over the edge. It's about that as well, it's about that kind of transformation. Hello, I'm on the
floor. No, man. No, no, no! No!
What else is it about? What's it about?
extra arm to the group. So it's a safe space for people to get off if they have to. But I didn't say that. You didn't want to take off, did you? Looks like you need a joke. What do you call a raven with a filing cabinet on his head? Sorted.
And I haven't, well, what I'm going to share with you, I haven't even symbol I might ask you. Can anyone please tell me what that symbol was?
I love it. I love you. Camera.
Who wants to play games?
You're Chris Wagner, the interviewer.
I can't hear anyone.
I'll make all of you.
Good. Everyone likes to play games.
The whole way.